Hey there, I'm Nancy from Catholic Sprouts. Today we are going to continue on the important work that we started when we defined the three keys to teaching our children the Catholic faith. The first is prayer, and I already talked about that in a previous video. You can find the link to that video below this video. If you've watched it, then let's dive into the second key. And the second key to teaching our children the faith is having a profound level of trust. Now, I know that sounds wacky, right? The first two keys to teaching our children the faith don't have anything to do with studying or actually teaching. They're praying and trusting. But let me tell you, when we teach our children the faith, we need the surest footing, the strongest foundation possible. And that is only achieved when we recklessly trust God in a profound way. Trust Him with the lives of our children. Trust Him with our own lives and our own efforts. These things are fundamental when it comes to teaching our children the faith. So before we get into this, let's talk about trust. Trust is one of those big words. It's also kind of one of those hard to nail down kind of words. And oftentimes the best we can do is just talk about words that are related to it or involved in the act of trusting. So I'm going to give you some things to think about. Now, trust, fully entrusting our lives to God, requires probably more than anything a surrender. A surrender that I'm not in control, an acknowledgement that I'm not enough, that I can't make myself holy, that I can never achieve heaven, that all of these things are gifts from God. And so trust requires surrender. It also requires, in a very real way, a death to self. And this is never more true than raising and teaching children. So often we have an idea in our heads about how things are going to go. This is especially true before we have children, isn't it? When we're single, sitting in mass, and we see a parent in front of us, you know, feeding their kid Cheerios or, you know, not doing what we think they should be doing, we assume that we'll do a better job and that our children will be better behaved. But if you're like me, you've had to eat those words over and over again because you realize that children are children and that parenting is hard and that things will not go the way that you planned for them to go. Having trust as a parent means that you accept this is part of God's plan. You get up every day and you keep trying, sure, but you really do trust that God's got this, that there's a bigger plan, and that if I remain faithful, He will remain faithful to me. And so that is why trust is so important. So now we're going to break this down a little bit more. What does it mean to really have a profound level of trust as a teacher of the faith for our children? First, in order to be a good teacher of our children, we need to be a trusting believer of the faith ourselves. We really do need to trust everything in the catechism, everything in the Bible. We need to trust our church. And so that strong trust and faith in the church can show through us, can be something we don't have to plan or work on. It can just be something that our children see and absorb. So we need to really think like, do I trust and believe in all that the Catholic Church professes? Do I trust that God is here with me? Do I really trust that God exists? Do I really trust that He has a plan for me and that He will take care of me? Do I trust that God is active in the world today? Do I trust that even if I fail, God has a plan and that this is part of something bigger? Do I trust that heaven exists? Do I trust that I can get there, that my suffering is meaningful? Do I trust all of those things? And so much like the first key to teaching our children the faith, prayer, the second key, trust, requires a lot of internal work. It requires us sorting out our own issues with mistrust, putting those things to bed, bringing them before God, lying them down at his feet, and asking him to heal us. Now, the journey of trust, fully entrusting ourselves into God's hands, is a journey we will walk our whole lives. We will only achieve full trust probably at the end of our lives. For all of us, we're all holding a little bit of something back, and it is a daily struggle to lay it down and surrender. So don't worry. Don't feel like you have to be perfect to be the teacher of faith for your children. I am not saying that because I am not perfect. I am simply saying we need to try. We need to really evaluate where the gaps in our trust are and how we can start working on those things. The next way that trust plays a key role in our work as a parent and teacher of the faith for our children is that we need to trust that God chose us for this vocation of parenthood, that he chose us for these children, that he chose us for this work. He chose us for this. Really, if you are a parent, you probably haven't experienced how incredible it is to be a parent, that you are part of something so much bigger than you. Entering into parenthood was just a profound experience of how true and loving God is. He chose me for this. Now, in the same way, St. Therese reminds us that God does not give us anything. He doesn't put any desire in our heart or give us any vocation that we can't live up to. He's not mean like that. If he put a desire in your heart, if he placed a vocation in front of you, he will allow you to live that out the right way. We need to trust that he is a loving God and trust he gave me these children. He gave me the vocation of motherhood. And because he is a good and just God, he will give me the tools and the virtues to do this well. This is what sustains us when the projects fail. This is what sustains us when our children get a little older and they doubt. This is what sustains us when things get really hard, which they will. A trust that God gave me this vocation. And God gave me these children, and therefore he will give me the tools and the virtues to live out this vocation well. And finally, faith and trust play such a key role in teaching our children because the work of teaching your children the faith can be boiled down to a phrase that I use all the time and that has been used by some powerful saints. We aren't called to be successful. We are called to be faithful. And also, we might not be able to do huge, amazing things, but we can do small things with great love. I know St. Therese and St. Mother Teresa of Calcutta use those phrases endlessly. And although they were not parents, what they said applies so well to the work of parenting. We might not be successful. Each and every tiny little thing that we do probably will not live up to the expectations that we have. And yet God tells us, don't be frustrated. I see what you're doing. It is valuable. In order to really believe that God sees value in our small work, we need to trust him. We need to trust that he is there, that he sees us, and that he loves us. And so, my friend, that is why trust is the second key to teaching our children the faith. We need to believe that God will give us what we need to live out this vocation. We need to trust in the teachings of the Catholic faith, and we need to trust that our small, sometimes unsuccessful work is still valuable, is still seen by God, and is still living up to what he's asking us to do. And so, in the next video, we're going to talk about, finally, about the work of teaching our children, which I am calling trying. Not succeeding, trying. So stay tuned for that video. It'll be coming your way soon. But before you do that, I really want to encourage you to do the work on establishing a personal prayer life and really entrusting yourself to God. I want to encourage you to sign up for a free 7-day course for Catholic moms called Reclaim the Day. If you are struggling to find time to pray every day, or you just feel like, well, that's impossible, there's no time for me to pray, then seriously, just go through this free course. So come to your email just a little bit a day. It is something that my pediatrician talked me through when I had just one little baby. Transform my life. It's all about reordering your priorities. Because even though you might feel like you don't have time to pray, I'm telling you, you do. You just have to rearrange things and put things in the right order. So please check that out. And also, if you want to learn more about St. Therese, I have a beautiful video on here about how the little way is really the key to becoming a better mom. And I will link to that in the show notes for this video. So anyways, thank you for being here. Come back for that next video on trying when we teach our children the faith. But until then, I encourage you to join me in the small, humble work of doing small things with great love, which is parenting, right? I'll see you soon.